Okay, on this problem, I wanted to show you how it's different to make a histogram on a Mac, just a little bit different. It's especially where you want to adjust your bins. So this is that Titanic data of the second class male survivors. If I select this data, I'm holding the shift down and I'm doing the down arrow on my keyboard. I'm not very good at the Mac keyboard. Then I will click on insert, and then I will come over here to the histogram. And then I'll choose this one. And that looks exactly like what we got when we were using a PC. The difference here is, you remember on a PC, I double clicked on these bins here and was able to adjust the bin width. That's not how you want to do it on a Mac. On a Mac, you want to click so that you select all of those rectangles. Notice how all of those rectangles are selected. And then if you double click on it, I can mess this up. Let's try that again. So notice when I double clicked on them, I got this format data series. So let me show, if I do one, I only have format data point, but if I select all of them and I'm really just randomly trying to get them all selected, there they all are selected. And now I have format data series. So I'm going to click on the series options, and then I'll see bins, and I'll change it to bin width. And remember, we wanted it to be 5-year bin widths. And we wanted the underflow bin, which would be the first bin, to be 20. And if we hit that, then it looks very similar to the way that you had it in a PC. And I think that's all. You can kind of mess around and do different things if you want. Like, you can change the colors and have some fun with this. I don't know if you want to do that, but hopefully I've changed your mind. You can do some of them. I don't know. That's probably not a good idea. But anyway, you can mess around with it. Feel free to play, because it's kind of fun. But that's how it's different with a Mac. Thank you for the question.